Hey, what's up guys? I'm back with another countdown for you all, and I've decided to call it the top 10 easiest skilling methods. And yes, I did see my typo about the most eastest 99 skills, and I am ashamed. So dang it, RuneScape, for teaching me how to type too fast. But anyway, what does Moplox mean by easiest? Well, first, I want you all to understand that I am not talking about the fastest methods, okay? So, fletching addy bolts for 500k XP per hour will not be on this list, I'm afraid, among other methods which other skills use that would cost you a bit of money and are sort of unrealistic, like cutting an onyx for 99 crafting XP. Those would be considered fast methods, but not particularly easy methods. So basically what I mean by easy is the skill is mostly AFKable, there's not many requirements to train it, and you don't have to spend that much gold while training the skill. So these methods could take a little bit of time to actually get level 99, but they are extremely easy, and quickness and how fast the method is not particularly what we're trying to count down here. So I suppose you could call this video the top 10 AFKable skilling methods, but I feel like calling it the top 10 easiest skilling methods clarifies more. So with all that being said, let's get into the countdown. Number 10, smithing. So smithing seems like it would be very hard to get 99 in, right? Well, I have level 80 smithing, and I will personally tell you how I got it to level 80 was with gold bars, goldsmith gauntlets, and again, some patience. I will probably end up getting 99 with this method because, again, I'm not really looking for fast results. Buy a bunch of gold ore, which at the moment the GE price of is 255 coins each, and go get the goldsmith gauntlets from the family crest quest and start making gold bars, preferably on the island of Natasnot for maximum efficiency, and you'll be making 55-56 XP per bar you make. Now, gold bars are 130 coins each, so at first it might seem like you're losing money, but what you could do is get some crafting XP in there as well and make those gold bars into gold bracelets. And after you've made all your bars into bracelets, go craft some nature runes and alk the gold bracelets for 330 coins each, which in turn will give you more money than what you spent on the gold ore in the first place. It's a very long method, but it's almost 100% AFKable, and the XP rate isn't too bad, and it's more than likely, as I said before, what I plan to do for 99 smithing because I'm lazy, and after all, this method is quite easy. Number 9. There's going to be so many jokes about it, but spinning flax after you buy it for crafting. Obviously, since flax is 15 GP each and bowstring can sell on the GE for 120 GP each, it will make you money but very slowly, and your crafting XP will be insanely slow too, but using this method would be insanely easy if you're trying to watch movies or YouTube while skilling or something, as everyone knows you can obviously AFK flax spinning. It's such a newbie thing to do and include on this countdown, I know, don't hate me, but it has to be mentioned as one of the most easiest methods for getting 99 crafting, and to those players out there who have gotten 99 crafting by spinning flax, you truly are a god. Number 8, woodcutting. The entire skill itself is just super easy, especially like at level 35 when you can start doing teak trees on Apatol or somewhere else, although I personally chose to wait to do that until I was level 60 woodcutting. It's great XP for the skill, but you literally earn no money off of it unless you chop user magic trees, but, you know, who wants to do that? Doing teaks, however, is the fastest way to get 99 though, and obviously if you're woodcutting them on Apatol, you will need your monkey gree. This method is very easy, requires little to no focus, and is very AFKable. Number 7. Worshipping dragon bones for prayer. Obviously, you're going to have to spend a little bit of money to be doing this method. However, there are some ways around being able to not use as much money and still gain some money for this method as well. But it does take time. You can go kill blue dragons if you wish to get the bones yourself, if you've got a high enough ranging level, or green dragons, which really doesn't take too much time, and then go sell the blue or green dragon hides you've also gotten from the dragons for 1.8k each, further adding to your cash pile that you may or may not want to use to buy even more bones than what you are getting per hour at the dragons also to keep worshipping. Really, the only thing you'd have to worry about is buying more broad bolts for ranging more dragons or PKers if you choose the wilderness route. Number 6. Barbarian fishing at Baxtorian Falls. Obviously, this is the best method for getting 99 fishing if you're mainly looking for just XP, also making it the fastest method too. I said I wasn't including fast methods, but this method is way too super easy to not include. If you want 99 fishing, the fastest way and the easiest way would be barbarian fishing, as you only need level 58 to catch both leaping trout and salmon, and you only have to spend money on feathers, and you can also just find the oily fishing rod needed for this method right inside the barbarian's house who teaches you the method when you start for your first time. Very easy, AFKable, and is pretty relaxing in my opinion. Number 5. Something I just spoke about, for 99 range, if you don't mind slowly getting to 99, but would rather not have to focus too much on the game itself, and are looking for the easiest method for 99, it would definitely have to be the Blue Dragons, because let's be honest, who wants to spend all that money on Red Chins? So, you make money here, and all you have to do is buy bolts to continue killing them. If you have 70 agility to get through the pipe, going back and forth from the cave to Fowley makes everything a lot easier too. There's also a safe spot you can use to never once be even touched by the dragons, and I love using this method if I ever don't necessarily want to escape hardcore and would rather watch a movie or something while playing instead, just to, once again, relax a bit. Number 4. Fletching, and specifically magic logs. Obviously buying magic logs is going to take a bit of money, and cutting them just to make them will take even longer. However, if you have already spun flax into bowstring, then you could potentially gain some money with this method, and the XP to get 99 is pretty good too. Cut the magic logs into unstrung magic longbows, and then take your bowstrings and string them together, obviously, and if you out the bows you've made, if you've already made nature runes with runecrafting, then outking the strung magic longbows you've created will give you 1,536 coins each longbow, which is more than what you did spend on one magic log, which the price of those right now is 1.1 to 1.2k. The best part about this method is that you do make money, even if it's slow. The XP is amazing, and obviously everybody knows fletching is very AFK. It's a win, win, win. Number 3. The experiments. Now, don't hate me for this, but this is a very easy method if you really want to get your combat stats up quick. They've got high amount of HP, and hitting them is pretty easy, and you usually don't have to eat too much food. Guys, I am a firm believer in training Slayer with combat stats, but obviously just killing something all day long like experiments without having to bank much or pause to go get a Slayer task is obviously going to be more experience for you in the long run if you just want to get your melee stats up to be a Staker or a PKer and don't care much for Slayer itself. It's very AFKable here, and like I said, if you don't care about Slayer gains and just want a high combat level, then this would be the easiest way for you to get 99 in your melee skills. I would include Nightmare Zone, but obviously not a lot of people have the equipment that they would need for maximum XP rates like Guthan's armor, so I'm sorry about that. Number 2. Alking. Now let's be honest guys, probably nobody alks legitimately, if you know what I mean, but alking is still very easy because all you have to do is click over and over, and not even at a rapid rate either, to get magic experience. Most people alk until 99 simply because it really is the easiest method for 99 in the skill. I would have included splashing here, but splashing really doesn't help you gain money or anything, and alking does depending on if you're crafting your own gnats or alking something for more profit than what its normal GE price is, like longbows or something. It's very self-explanatory, and overall the most easiest method for training magic. Number 1. Blackjacking to 99 thieving. Now I know this one really isn't AFK, but I'm including it simply for the fact that I didn't want this video to seem like a top 10 AFKable skills or something. Blackjacking in the desert on the Menophyte Thugs is super fast XP to 99, and you can pretty much either choose to do this or Pyramid Plunder if you wish for 99 thieving, but I personally feel like blackjacking is a lot easier in my opinion. It's very click intensive, but overall, it really is the easiest way to 99 thieving, and if your health gets too low, obviously you can go to the bar right around the corner and buy more wines and beer for regaining your HP with the money you get from doing this, which isn't much money at all itself, but it does add up the longer you do this, and at the end of the day, of course, it is free money anyway, so who doesn't like that? Thanks for watching, guys. I know this countdown may have seemed opinionated, or maybe it should have been called the top 10 most AFKable skilling methods, but nonetheless, I still felt like calling it the easiest methods is actually more what this video represents anyway, so if you disagree, I am really sorry, but that's just how I feel. We're coming up on 3 million views on the channel, and it's almost 34,000 subscribers already, and that's just insane, so thank you guys once again for being so cool all the time. That's all I gotta say, and I will talk to you guys later.